In this video, I'm going to show you how to add 3D text behind objects inside DaVinci Resolve. So let's get right into it. So I've already got my timeline open and a B-roll waiting, and the first thing we're going to do is right-click our clip and then create a new Fusion clip. Now we're going to head over straight to Fusion. So here in Fusion, as you can see, we have our Media 1, which is our clip, and our Media Out, where everything we do in between here is being rendered. So let's take a look at the footage first. Okay, so as you can see, we have a moving camera. So in this case, we're gonna have to do some tracking. And in this case, we're gonna use the planner tracker. So all you gotta do is click on the media one, then hit shift spacebar on the keyboard and look for the planner tracker. We're gonna add it to the node tree. We're gonna close the media pool. We can have more space here. We're gonna zoom in a little bit and we're gonna select these two buildings right here. I've already made a video here on the channel showing how to use the planner tracker. I'll leave the link to it in the description of this video in case you wanna watch it. So let's do this. Okay, now we're gonna come to the tracking properties and we're gonna set a reference time or keyframe 0. Here on motion type, we're gonna change it from perspective to translation since we've only got a simple camera tilt going on. Now all we have to do is hit track to end and let Resolve do its thing. Okay, the tracking is complete. Now we're gonna hit create planner transform and all the information about the tracking will be inside this little node right here. So let's leave it aside for a while and now we can delete the planner tracker. Okay, let's reframe our window. Now, we're gonna close the inspector and we're gonna add a 3D text node and the renderer 3D into the node tree. We're gonna connect the text 3D with the renderer 3D and the renderer 3D with our media 1. Now, let's click on our text, open up the inspector and write something. I'm gonna write 3D, but right now it just looks like a regular 2D text. And to make this look 3D, we have to come down here to extrusion and increase the extrusion depth. Like, this is fine. So now if I come to transform and rotate the Y axis, you'll see we've got a 3D text, but let's make it better. Let's click on our text 3D, hit shift spacebar on the keyboard, and add a replace material 3D. Now we're gonna come to effects, templates, fusion, shaders, and we can choose between many types of materials right here. I'm gonna choose this one I like, chrome. We're gonna connect it to this green arrow right here on the replace material 3D node, like this, and we've got a much better looking 3D text. Let's close the effects, let's go to our text, make it a little bit smaller. This is fine. Now what we gotta do is copy our media one, and we can do that by hitting Command or Control C on the keyboard and then pasting it right here, hitting Command or Control V. We're gonna connect it to our node tree right after the merge one, like this. And now as you can see, our text got covered by the footage again. So now is where the magic happens. We're gonna make a kind of a double layer. We're gonna mask out these buildings so the text is visible between the buildings and the background. So now is when the planner transform comes in handy. We're gonna place it right here under our merge tool and connect it to this blue mask input right here. Now we're gonna grab this polygon node, and very important, we have to connect it to this yellow input of the planner transform, not in this blue one. Keep that in mind. So now let's zoom in our viewer and mask out our buildings, like this. Let's reframe our window. See, now the text is visible. So now let's make it even more fun and make the text go up while rotating. So how do we do that? We're gonna click on our text, we're gonna come to transform. So let's go to the beginning of the video and we're gonna set a keyframe on the Y axis under translation and another keyframe on the Y axis under rotation. Now we're gonna go to the last frame of the video and here in translation, we're gonna make our text go way up high. Like here is fine. And here on rotation, we're gonna write 1080 to make it rotate 1080 degrees. So now, let's see how the effect looks. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you wanna know more about DaVinci Resolve, check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.